So I remove the comb and the, well, the claw weights and then the comb. But before I go on, of course, you see I have the needles brought out to hold position. But now this is where I'm just going to pull these stitches off the gate pegs. If I don't, your knit-in may not work properly because it's not going to be weighted good enough. Now the pattern says to knit 17 rows without shaping. Now here the pattern says to mark these stitches, but again, I don't need that. If you need it, go ahead and mark it there. Now to do the leg, it says cast on 13 stitches at the beginning of the next two rows. So again, just like the other part here, see it doesn't look like a booty, it's just sitting out there. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. Again, this is the reverse E-wrap. And it may seem odd to you that the carriage is on the left. As I've mentioned many times before, it doesn't matter. I know a lot of patterns says to have the carriage on the right, have the carriage on the left. But I omit a lot of that. And this pattern here, I did not see anything about carriage on right or carriage on left. So it's not always needed. So I knit across. Again, I'm going to bring these needles out, and actually even those, out to hold. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. Knit across, and I could put my cast on comb back on. And the good thing with this is I could have it like this, it doesn't really matter with this one, because you do have to put the claw weights on. But as you see, I go up on an angle so I can get that end stitch without grabbing that yarn. Then I bring it down on the rest of the stitches or the work. Hang my claw weights there. Okay, knit three rows without shaping. So, 1, 2, 3. And then repeat the coloring on the top here 3 times. So I take the white out. I put my side levers back to the Roman numeral 2. I bring every other needle out. I put the other color into the yarn. I knit 2 rows. And I probably should put a clip on there. Take the contrast and color out, put it on the left, on the right. And because I have to do this again, I'm going to bring those needles back to the forward working position. Knit 2 rows. Take the white out. Put the red back in, every other needle out to hold position, knit 2 rows, red out, white in, push the needles back, knit 2 rows. And one more time. White out, red in. Bring every other needle out to hold. Knit 2 rows. And this is the end of the contrast and color. I could go ahead and cut it here. Put the white back in. I could do one of 2 things. I could push the needles back like I did before, or I could take the lever here on the left and just put it up to Roman numeral 1, and it'll knit all the stitches and knit 2 rows. finally knit four rows and bind off. So let me bind off and then I'll show you how to sew this up. So you have this odd shape and piece here. But what I do is, and of course with this I'm using my small tapestry needle, and somebody had asked me how I thread my needles. I pinch the end of the yarn there, which is just good enough to get it through the eye of the needle. If you have a problem there, you could do what Cheryl does. Take the yarn, loop it around the needle, squish it, and then thread it. But I find even just the single one, oh, I'm on the wrong yarn anyways. But I'm taking a piece of thread, yarn, from this part here, because you need to sew this part up first. So I take, and I always put right sides together. And I go from one side to the other, doing basically a running stitch. And this is the same thing as doing a mattress stitch. And so much easier. So with the white, as you see, I'm sewing down onto the red. In the end, because I don't want to weave these small stitches, I just put the needle back through a loop of yarn. I take the yarn from here that goes to the eye, wrap it around the needle twice, pull that through, it makes a nice little knot, and I could cut that off. But I have to take this red piece of yarn and sew the top part of this. So I have to backtrack a little bit. See, the yarn's right here, and I need to go back there. I could have done the same with the white. But what I do is go down the two stitches. And now I have that there, and then I can go back into the first stitch here. And just go back and forth, grabbing the outside loop of the end stitches. You don't have to go two loops on this. And especially with this yarn, I'm not really sure. This is kind of like a fingering yarn here in the U.S. I guess it's very similar to the four-ply over in the U.K. and Australia. And again, I am going to knot that yarn. Now I have these little tiny hair clips that come in handy for holding your work together. So I find the back of this, find the center, doesn't have to be exactly there, but I put that, line it up with the seam I just sewn. I clip that in place. So now I need to sew if I could flatten this out good enough. I should probably start on the other side. There is the two tails over here. The pinkish red color one I'm going to have to knot up later on. But as you see, it kind of lines up there. I'm going to take, well, the pink one's a little bit longer, although I got the white at the top there. If you don't have a long enough length, just grab another length of yarn and sew around the whole side there. Thought I had it. Sometimes when the yarn frays like that, I will go ahead and twist it as it's twisted already, and then I will squish it again to get it through the eye. And because I'm right-handed, I like going to the left. So again, I just do a run-in stitch, grabbing one loop. Now one is a cast on and one is the side work. The white here is the side work. The pinkish color is the cast on. And you may not get it lined up just right, taking one stitch with each one. You may have to skip a stitch on the white, but that's all right. It's still going to work out. So now I just need to sew all around the bottom of the foot here, which is actually this part right here. So after you get this bottom part sewn up, of course I went and cut off the extra lengths of yarn. What I did was I took the leg part and I already sewed up the back of the leg, so that's going to go there. I did have a nice long tail in the beginning. Now if you don't, of course you take another one. And of course, for those of you that don't want to do it the way I show it, you could start here, you could sew around that in place, you're going to have to sew the back of that later. This way here, by sewing the back, I could go around, go to the front here. There's only, what, six stitches over here. I could go across to the other side and then sew around the back side and tie it off. So I do try to make things as simple as possible. Not always, but... Now, if you marked it, see, there's things that are going to be, you would have marked there and here. Those markers would have lined up right there. But as I'm sewing this, it lines up perfectly, so I don't have to mark it as the pattern did state. So I try to flatten it out as best as possible. And just to, let's see, I'm on the right side of that, so I want to go to the right side of this seam. And then I'm going to go to the left side of the seam and then just continue my run-in stitch. And I push, hold the material together so that I could see the stitches. Now here I am grabbing the two outside stitches, the two yarns that makes up one stitch. If you want to do the one outside loop of that stitch, you could do that too. Just because I show something one way doesn't mean that you have to do it that way. Some people get so uptight. So again, I'm going to sew along the side here. When I get to the toe, I'm going to weave it across the toe or just go through a loop and then sew the other side. When I'm done, I'll knot it off and it's all done. Turn it inside out and this is what you have. Now, I've seen some patterns where you could take a chain, make a bow, and sew it in place just to give it a little extra look there if you want.